Hello everyone, and welcome to a blind attempt at playing the demo of Solium Infernum, a turn-based strategy game created by Cryptic Comet and released on November 26, 2009. I recently heard of the game from, of all people, Jeff. He was looking for something interesting to play and stumbled across this, and I thought I would download the demo and give the game a shot. As this is the first time I've played the game, though, I haven't even played the game yet. My knowledge is extremely limited, I know practically nothing of what I'm about to do, and I wouldn't recommend doing this with games you plan on recording, but I thought some of you might be interested in discovering something with me. Exploration, together. Fancy that. So, yes, Solium Infernum, I think you play as an Archfiend of Hell, and your ultimate goal is to become the ruler of Hell. Sounds like a goal worthy of Grimith, so let's get started, shall we? Create and edit avatar? Sure, we'll do that. Now, I actually have something that I was messing with. I was just faffing about. Like a few minutes ago. So let's just delete what I was faffing about with and create another avatar. So we have like this whole character creation process. I presume the avatar actually carries on to the game. That would be cool. You have a bunch of different attributes that affect various things in the game. You can pick a pretty picture. I think I like that one the best. So, by pretty picture, I mean... Okay, so it's not that pretty. Well, let's get this straight. Hello, lady. Perhaps not. Yeah, I think I'm gonna stick with this one. And name Grimace, select a public objective category. These are things I think your goal is to achieve by the end of the game, and you get a prestige bonus from doing so. Victory through prestige is one of the primary ways of winning the game. I think I'm going to go ahead and be a glutton, consume 35 souls by the end of the game. That actually gives me additional 3 fiend points. And I can select perks as well. These are various attributes. These rise steeply in cost. Observe. If I wanted to be a master of the martial prowess field, raising that to 4 subtracts 30 points. Yeah. Oh, also you can select an infernal rank. That controls a vast variety of things in the game. For the time being, I'm just going to be a Lord of Hell. It affects, really, how you deal with, like, other demon lord dudes. So we have a bunch of interesting perks and de-perks. Like, oh, goodness, disgraces. Like, debuffs. I can't think of the right terminology. Regardless, they exist. I'm just gonna pick some stuff, I guess. I can scroll through them, take a look. Something that I think sounds worthy of Grimith. I don't know. What sounds worthy of Grimith? Everybody, this is the part where you tell me. Through YouTube, or through your monitor screen right now. I know it'll be too late. Oh! And these are like additional ways you can win the game too. By picking one of these perk things, it's all sneaky. You are a master manipulator who can rule from the shadows. If you are the blood vassal to a bloodlord who wins the game, then you win instead. And a kingmaker thing. Yeah. All sorts of sneaky ways to be a douche and win. I don't know. Well, we're off to a great start, aren't we? With the I don't know thing. I like this unnatural prescience thing. I have an odd ability to see into the future manipulate to my advantage. So I'm gonna select that. I can see into the future, everyone. You should be terrified. You should be scared and scared. Ichor Rejuvenation, Infernal Cardinal, Devoted Minions. Your minions are cultists or zealous in their search for tribute. You gain an additional tribute choice each time tribute is demanded from your followers. That could be valuable, sure. Obscure, -2 penalty, slothful. All legions receive a -1 movement penalty, debauched. Receive a -1 modifier to the number of order slots you receive per turn. I think those are supremely important, so I wouldn't want to sacrifice those. Are there any other subtractions? The answer to that question is no. I bet we close out of that for the time being, and get some boosts. I want some charisma. I want intellect. Cunning, martial prowess, I don't know about all that. They only cost 2 points to increase by 1, though. And 4 points to increase this next part. So I think that's cool. Is there a perk that costs 3? The answer to that question, of course, is no. Oh, hey! Right. Instead of being a Lord of Hell, I can be a Baron of Hell. Alright, so... okay, we're going with that. I've saved this avatar, you're goddamn right. So this is me, Grimith. We're rolling with this. Cancel, single player, normal game, new game. Map size, I suppose I really can't do a whole lot here. Courtesy of the fact that I'm playing the demo. Makes sense, doesn't it? I shall be Grimith. Hooray! This where I change my symbol? I think so. So what symbol do I wish to have? Which will inspire the most terror and fear? The all-seeing eye. Okay, we can choose a bunch of random dudes here to be our opponents. We have Asmodeus, Astaroth, Azazel, I don't really know my demonic names, by the way. Balthagor, Beelzebub, Belial, Barith, Lilith, Mammon, Moloch, Murmur, Oribus, Aimon, Shax, and Citri. Okay, so... we'll just pick a bunch of Randorg people. Randorg, 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 Randorg. We'll have a full house of Randorg. Places of power, I'll just leave that stuff alone. Please amuse yourself while the inferno is created. This may take some time. So, hello everybody. Greetings! How are all of you? Fantastic. Do you like the smell of adventure? Of course you do. I just recorded some Civil War Generals 2, by the way. How do you all feel about that? I know, I did a battle. Cool stuff. I have some Mountain Dew, which you may not believe this, but does not actually come from the mountains. How are all of you? I guess I could have paused the recording. Maybe I'll do that. Yeah, I guess I'll do that. Hold on, everybody. Okay, so it only took like an additional 35 seconds after I ended the recording, and we're here on the screen. We have a spiffy little turn log here. The Scepter of Regent of the Infernal Throne has passed to Azazel this turn. Basically, Satan or Lucifer, whoever the fuck controlled the throne, he's gone.
He is no more. He has ceased to be.
So we're all competing to be that, and each turn, a regent is randomly determined, and they can, like, interfere with shit. They get, like, some event cards that they can draw to, basically fuck with everything. We have some tribute from my minions. We only have 4 events that have popped up, so, yes. Well, cool. Let's go inspect our potential tribute. I get to choose 2. There are 4 different types of resources in the game. I can't name them all at the top of my head right now. So, I'm going to choose the most valuable ones. Okay, okay. So, this is Ichor. These are souls, hellfire, and darkness. Alright, the fuck do I scroll out? Return one. Blood of Grimith. I guess that's a legion of mine? Yeah, that's my starting legion. That's my stronghold. Never lose your stronghold. If you lose your stronghold, you lose the game. Because anyone who can't defend their stronghold is obviously not worthy of living in hell. Okay. So, how's our legion looking here? View. The personal guard of Grimith has sworn to defend their lord or spend an incorporeal eternity in the Abyss trying. Their loyalty is unquestioned. They have a flame aura, apparently. That's cool. Stronghold is captured, destroyed, then the Archfiend is banished to the Abyss for an eon. Okay. I don't have any praetors, artifacts, and relics, or events. These guys, they look cool. Yeah. So, my neighbor here is Belial. Could my dudes kick Belial's ass? Well, possibly. Possibly. I mean, equal level, they have slightly more health. Ranged attack comes first, though, they have slightly more than that. Melee I win at, and I have additional infernal power, too. And one more hit point, so maybe I could take them out, but I probably couldn't take out the stronghold with them, too. Okay, so that shows me this. Tribute. Rituals. Diplomacy. Okay, here's our diplomatic screen that I read about, where we can see all of our friends, and we can even adjust our threats. Which I think you can do for free in the first 10 turns. I don't remember how long the demo is. It might just be 10 turns. I don't know. Okay. I don't know. So, what if I press the plus or minus keys? No, that doesn't zoom me out either. Can I not zoom out? Well, surely I could be able to zoom out. Scrolling on this map? Okay, we can do that. Slaves of Beelzebub. They're fierce. Interesting. I don't know what that does, either. Maybe I need to pull out the fucking manual. Slaves of Belial. Okay. So the world wraps in on itself. That's good to know. That's good to know. The Bronze Pyramid, Chosen of Azazel. The Temple of the Damned. The Stronghold, Chosen of Balfagor. Wow. Those two really neighbor each other. Where's Pandemonium? Oh, okay, there's Pandemonium. Holy crap. Wow. Okay, Pandemonium is right there. That is the home city of the Infernal Conclave. Attacking that will excommunicate you from the Infernal Conclave, meaning that everyone can attack you. Okay. If I click on that... Oh, hey! There we go. Oh my goodness. Those are the only two zoom levels I have. Oh boy. Conclave tokens, whenever those get to 15, the game ends. That doesn't mean there are only 15 turns left in the game. It's just like a random chance draw thing. Okay, folks, so... Right. I suppose I should try to take some of these places. Although, I don't know whether my legion's strong enough to handle that shit. He might die. I do not want my legion to die, folks. That would be disappointing. This is what happens whenever you're not a martial leader, I reckon, because that's what I'm not. Okay. Orders. Okay. I could demand tribute. Bid on some shit. Bid on a relic, bid on a manuscript, give a legion orders, create a combat card. Make a diplomatic effort. No, play an event card. I don't have any of those. Manage objectives. I don't even have any souls to consume anyway. Expend tribute to increase your attributes. Tell you what. How about we create a combat card for my dude? The Blood of Grimith. Dummy card plus dick. I guess I'm not surprised. I can't do that much anyway. Since I don't really have a whole lot of war stuff. So, maybe I go visit the bazaar. What do we have here? What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? A severed head from the ability to jump over hexes, the Order of Infernal Engineers. Chance to recover enemy artifacts is doubled. The Bane of the Righteous. Grinning Legion. Ooh. Now, you have to bid on shit, by the way, if you're not noticing. And, some things, I think, have, like, an upkeep as well. So, they can be expensive to maintain. None of these guys have an upkeep, though, which is cool. But there's no guarantee that I'd be able to get any of them anyway. I could also, try to get a Praetor. Although, I don't have a whole lot of resources, so obviously, the first thing I need to do is to demand resources from my dudes. Obviously, that's the first thing I need to do. I could spend another turn doing that as well. Do you like the smell of adventure? Do you like a man who smells like a cake? Ooh! I don't know whether my dude can take these places on, but I bet he could take... Oh, crap. That's pretty far. I bet he could take that on, though. Okay. So, sure. Let's march in that direction. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. And we'll attack that place. I think that's a place I can take. So I'm excited. Okay. And that takes care of my turn. I don't think I get any more orders. Yeah, I don't have any more orders remaining. Dick. So, that's the best I can do, folks. I don't have an order slot available, so I can't do much of anything. And I think that'll be that. So, let's go ahead and end turn and see what happens. There's a message that requires you make a choice before you end your turn. What message? Let's take a look. Oh! There's only like 3 tribute events. Holy shit! Oh, goodness. How much of that do I have? I have 2 of the fire stuff. I'll have 3 souls. Maybe I won't end my turn right now, then. Is there anything I could bid on, possibly, with this stuff? I'm interested in having a Praetor. Minimum bid, I can't afford you. Different legion, perhaps? No. I think I'll just have to wait for another turn. Okay. Cool. All players are planning out their turn. AI players are planning out their turns, rather. Grimith can read! So this is a multiplayer game. You can play this with multiple people. From what I've read of the game, that can be really fun. As you're all basically archfiends, you can all backstab and be dicks to each other and stuff like that. It can be exciting. Obviously, this is just single-player demo. It's obviously not the latest patched version of the game. Let the AI finish planning out its shit. I don't even know how good the AI is. Well, if it kicks my ass in one turn. Well, that was fun, everybody. Good game. Loading up. Okay, tribute from your minions has arrived. Ooh, nice. Grimith approves. Grimith approves. Okay. That's no good. Who is the dude man? Balfagor. Slaves of Beelzebub. Can they attack that? Can they take that? Maybe. Maybe I've underestimated my dude man's capabilities. I should remember to use my arrow keys. Folks appear to be beelining after this little shitty place here. I appear to be the closest one. I don't like the idea of leaving my place so undefended. Not a fan. Well, if I lose, I will learn something very important. Maybe I should get a secondary legion, just in case. Grinning Legion and the Scourge of God. Okay. Loyalty. You look good. 3, 4, 3. I could just barely afford you. Am I sure I want to do that? Well, couldn't hurt, right? Let's go ahead and select phase 2 for that. And I will... Holy crap. Okay, I can do this, everybody. Do that. Do that. Am I doing this wrong? I think I am. Commit that. I think I'm doing this wrong. Maybe we'll just commit tribute? Okay. Minister orders. Okay. And now, for this thing, I'm not exactly demanding tribute this time, though. Oh well. March Legion. There. That will come first. Okay. Let's roll with it. Mules on wheels, children. Mules on wheels. Let's do this shit. In turn. AI's planning out their turn. They're much quicker now. Oh, your bid for the Grinning Legion has failed because you did not commit enough resources. Oh. Service of the Infernal Legion known as the Dark Thing. I don't think I did it right, everybody. It's not the first time I did it wrong. I have no idea what the fuck I'm doing. No idea. So I guess I can separate these out into pretty little stacks of stuff. I guess that's cool. Whatever happened, folks, I did it wrong. And for that, I apologize. Rumors of weakness. Play this event to cause a random opponent to lose 2d6 prestige. Interesting. So, my friend over there's... Oh, fuck me. Okay, let's try this again. I wasted a turn there. That's not good. Okay. Children, the light bulb just went on inside my brain. I feel enlightened. I'm also going to be expend. I get it now! I get it! I'm gonna lose the game, but I get it. Okay. Order. Move Legion. Or give Legion orders, rather. Select. Right click there, and He might attack me. He would... Yeah, I think he would win. No, he can't attack me just yet. Right. We need to have, like, a blood feud before they can attack my stronghold. So they can't attack just yet. I think. That'd be a great thing to figure out, wouldn't it? Okay, so I just wasted a turn. It's no big deal. It's only a demo. I'm only learning the game. Nobody panic. Panic! Okay. Victory! Your Legion Blood of Grimith has defeated the summit of Mount Erebus. You have won 4 prestige points as a result. And the service of... And I won the auction. The Unholy Relic has been acquired by an unknown Archfiend. Basilbub is now the Infernal Regent. I need to collect some tribute, dudes. I need some tribute. Okay. So, I am the victor, that is mine, and I will gain +1 prestige per turn, courtesy of holding that. Hello, guys. Unclaimed. I would probably want to work in a little team effort of sorts to try and take that. So... I could also stay back and defend my places. Right. So, let's see here. I think what I need to do this turn is demand tribute from my dudes. I need to tribute cakes. Now. Plocks. And I don't feel like doing anything else. I'm in the lead, everybody! That might make me a target. I'm in the lead! I'm doing it! Kind of. Sort of. Maybe I could take some of these places? I don't know. I just don't know enough about the game. We shall see. So, I'm in your way, I think. Maybe you can go through that stuff, so maybe it's not a big deal. Manuscripts, tribute from my minions has arrived. Let's take the most valuable stuff, and... Dick. Let's just take some stuff there. Okay, we have one of these... Hellfire things. So, you're all put off by that. Okay, you're attacking there. You're not doing that bad. You have the power of black lightning. Interesting. Okay. Forces. Gaining my +1 prestige per turn. So, who do you suppose are my biggest threats here? Belial? Basilbub, I would dare say, are number 1 and number 2. So let's adjust my threats. That'll be fine. Belial and Basilbub are pretty much my neighbors here. Down here we have Azazel. To my north we have Barith. The furthest away dude is Balfalgor. So, Barith or Azazel? Who do you think is the most threatening one? I'm gonna go with Barith, and then Azazel. Okay? Okay. So... cancel. Belial, Balthagor, Barith, Azazel. That works for me. Right. So... order should be to... collect more tribute? I would dare say. Or maybe, you know, I'm interested. Let's go ahead and play our event card. Rumors of... Oh, shit, that costs so much. We don't have that kind of... those kinds of resources right now. But we're getting plus one prestige return. I probably didn't need to spend the resources to claim a second legion. But I was a little suspicious. Perhaps I could work on taking that down? It's ranged 8, melee 4. That could hurt. No, let's just go ahead and claim warp tribute now. Resources to destroy my foes. Hopefully the AI is actually terrible in this game. I would really wish that he would retreat, though, but hey. What's a guy to do? Zazel has taken ownership of the Temple of the Damned. So he did. He actually Pwnzord that thing pretty handily. Okay, what else we got? Tribute for my minions has arrived. Sweet. Claim some good old-fashioned tribute. And some of that stuff. I have a lot of souls now. You can have your tribute card stolen from you, I think. That would be decidedly unfortuitous. So, I guess I'm gonna go attack that place with the dudes. You're in my way, bro. You are in my way. It's okay. Never mind the fact that that's my most powerful dude. It's okay. Borders. Can I? I suppose I could. If I had enough stuff. I don't. That cost a lot of that. That cost a variety of things. Something to keep in mind, then. Demanding resources, very important. And maybe I will march you... Dick. Maybe I will march you over here. Okay, so... And we'll take that spot. No, we probably won't. Let's just demand more tribute. I would need both my legions there, or at least my chosen legion. Okay. I'm playing like this is gonna be for the long haul, I guess, even though I know it's only a demo. Tribute for my minions has arrived. What do we got for me? What do we got? We need some of that stuff. What do we need more of here? That goes to there, so I guess we'll take some more of this stuff. Okay. You're still there. I'm still watching over this, waiting to poach it, I guess. Where are you moving to? I don't know. I guess I'll slowly wrap around, or... Do I think I could take you? Well, we gotta have some fun, right? We're evil, right? Right! Who are you? You are Basil Bub. Make a diplomatic effort towards Basil Bub. Hurl an insult. I like it. Let's hurl an insult. And I'm not giving him anything. Yep, that's cool with me. Hurl an insult at you. And then I will move Legion, the Grinning Legion. March. There we go. That's good. I like it. Let's see the consequences of my actions. I hurled an insult at you, Basilbub. What should you do? So yeah, Vendetta is not the same as a blood feud. You need to have like 3 Vendettas before you can have a blood feud. You can't attack somebody's stronghold until then, unless either you or the opponent has been excommunicated from the Infernal Conclave. That's when all rules are off. Anyone who's been excommunicated can attack anything, and they can be attacked by anything. But if you've been excommunicated, you can't, like, bid on stuff in the bazaar, and you obviously can't participate. If everyone is excommunicated, I think the Infernal Conclave just dissolves. And I don't know whether winning by prestige is possible anymore. So yeah, you can win by prestige in this game. You can win by... You can win by taking Pandemonium and holding it for like 5 turns. And you can win through the various sneaky ways like Kingmaker or Power Behind the Throne or something. So, Basilbub has been insulted, but he's forced to make a response next turn. Belial actually took that space with his dude mins. Oh good, you actually moved out of my way. How generous of you to do that. So, Fagor, the manuscript bleeding wound has been required. So, let's go ahead and bestow orders here. Give Legion orders, Blood of Grimith, select. He has control over it! Simply by moving his Legion through that, he has control over it? Dick. Well, shit, it didn't matter even if he did get out of my way, did it? Fuck. I'm very I did not know that, moving your Legion through shit would establish a zone of control like that. In that case, I don't want to move them in case that, I get my vendetta upon you. And actually, well, no, I should have done that sooner, huh? Maybe not. Let's just demand tribute. Demand resources. You must construct additional resources. Okay. Excuse me. What you got, game? What you got? All this trash talking, might be about to make something interesting happen. I hurled an insult. I did. Could be funsies. Let's see what happens. Defeat! Your legion has been... Oh, dick. It appears he completely died? Yeah, he completely died. I did not know that would happen. I thought that it would be like a partial combat situation. That was a foolish mistake on my part. Basilbub has accepted your insult in full view of the Conclave and lost 4 prestige points. That's nice. He did, however, just purchase another legion. And I've lost mine. Oh, great. And I have drawn another event card. So, that leaves me with, perhaps, 2 event cards I'm holding. That could be interesting to play. I am interested in playing that card. At least I succeeded on my insult, though. Rumors of weakness cost a play. I can throw up three souls. Where are you guys at? So do I have like a twosies and a onesies? Nope, I only have threesies. Okay. Alright, I understand the game now. I'm gonna go ahead and give a Legion orders. I really need to increase my attributes. Most of your attributes, whenever you increase them to like 4 or past that, they'll give you +1 to the amount of orders you can issue. Very useful, getting more turns, I wager. I guess I should slowly march around. I understand more about the game now. Very peculiar. Very peculiar, that. I get it now, though, okay, folks? I get it. I understand so much. Also, he's level 4 now. Okay. Let's see what happens as a result of my actions. Terrain is worth the event. Rumors of weakness did not have sufficient resources. Oops. I think I forgot to contribute the second part of it. This is the last turn in which you may adjust your threat order list in the diplomacy screen without cost. The threat list basically adjusts how costly it'll be to do various things. I guess that's like the Regent symbol. So that was a waste of... Yeah, I forgot to contribute those three things. That was like a waste of an order. March Legion. Select for phase 2. So... Dick. That place actually healed up all the way. You won't be able to take that. Then again, what am I doing moving around my guy? I don't think I'll be able to do anything. Either. Let's just sob profusely. Maybe I can go to the bazaar instead, get one of these Praetor dudes. That could be fun. I don't have enough for you. I have enough for you. Melee +5. I have enough for you, too. Collector of artifacts. Interesting. Infernal +4. I'm not interested in that. Attack 13. Okay, I guess I do have enough for you. 5, 6. So who would I want here? You have additional luck. In a melee combat situation, you're also less loyal. I will place a bid upon you, as a matter of fact. 5 souls. 5 souls. And 6 blood foods. Blood sausages stuffs. 5 and 1. No. No, Grimith, you did it wrong. That's actually 6. Anything else? No. Okay. Demand resources. Alright, I understand a little bit about the game now. Okay, okay. Everything makes sense now, folks. Everything makes sense now. Scratch my beard stubble. So what happens now, game? Is it actually over? Is the demo actually over? Or have I forgotten something? Wait for the AI to plot out its turns here. The services of the Infernal Legion, I've won the auction for this dude. Oh, so maybe it's not over. Okay. I've won the auction for you. Fantastic. Manage Praetors. I would like to transfer you to the blood of Grimith. And then I would like to give Legion orders. Move you guys around. Level 4. He might try to do a concentrated attack on that thing. He might. Oh, Belial does control that, and I just never noticed. Crap, no wonder why he's leading in prestige. Which is what he is doing, is it not? Forces diplomacy. He is. It's okay. I'm learning how to play anyway. It's okay. Maybe it goes to 15 turns. Maybe it goes to 20. Maybe the game's actually generous and demo will actually be a full game. Whoa! Friends! Oh boy. That's great. I can take them on. I can do that. Orders. Move Legion. The Blood of Grimith. March Legion. Here. And then demand more tribute. Alright. In turn. Not really thinking about these things all the way through. Just messing around with the game. What happens next? I don't think I'm in a good position, but I get the impression that in this game, things can change pretty fast, especially if you capture somebody's stronghold. Azazel took Dude, that wasn't even cool. Dude, just like swooped in from the galaxy. Well, there was that bridge there. Dude, we have a personal problem now. Okay. That makes me angry now. Order. Diplomatic effort towards Azazel. Make demand. I demand 2 tribute cards. Oh yeah, I'm pissed now. Fuck it. Demand resources. Oh yeah. Let's fucking do this shit. I want to see some action here. I want to see some blood spew forth. I can take you. Maybe. I'm not even a dude who's seeking martial prowess. Ah, fuck it. I'll risk it. It could be fun. Let's have some fun. You want to have some fun, everybody? Let's have some fun. Oh. What did I forget? Tribute! That's kind of important. So I have 12 souls, 2 ichor, 6 hellfire, and 9 darkness. That's ichor, not blood. There's a difference. Alright. He will receive what I wrote, sent him this upcoming turn, and it will take him a turn to reply. Now, of course, he might reject the man, which would cost me 8 prestige, but then I would have the right to declare vendetta upon him. Ooh. Claim that. We have ourselves a lot of hellfire now. Ah, look at you, backing up. I'm taking this thing. Watch, you'll give me the 2 tribute cards and I'll be like, well, son of a bitch. It's okay. Melee damage. Tent of the Flayed Apostles. Banner of the Flayed Tent of the Flayed Apostates, my bad. At 4 legions level for purposes of combat and resistance rolls and determining the number of attachment slots. Okay, so let's take a look at everything I can do. What if I try to increase an attribute of mine? Maybe say intelligence. Maybe I might need to gear myself more towards combat. We'll say intelligence, though. And I can go ahead and throw in that tribute there. Let's see. We need some of this. We're gonna need some of that. Throw in some of those. I have a one fire thing. Do I have a three souls? I do. Good. Everything is good. Increase my intelligence. Intellect me! Combat deception, select enemy legion. Demonic. All friendly legions get a loyalty bonus. Players require information about his opponent's target player, which you are. Interesting. And Infernal Affliction. Interesting. I'll have to keep those in mind. I will demand tribute now. And patiently wait. Watch. You know, we're gonna go into a vendetta situation, and then I'm gonna attack this, and I'm gonna totally lose, and I'll just sob profusely, like... Although the game might end. Again, I don't know exactly when the demo ends. Game's been interesting thus far. I don't see any reason why it wouldn't be interesting. Congratulations, you have advanced your intellect to 3. Azazel has conceded to your demand for 2 tribute cards. You may not make another demand for 3 turns. Sweet! And a conclave token has been drawn. I may keep 2 event cards, so let's go ahead and collect some tribute first. Very nice. Very nice. So, I'm gonna have to, I can only keep 2. What is this evil sleeps thing? I think I want to keep that. I think I'll just get rid of that rumors of weakness thing. We'll just pretend that I used it. I can only keep so many of those cards. My power level, by the way, and prophecy is 3, courtesy of my intelligence. Powers, that means I have infernal negotiations. Player also gets a +2 whenever defending action does not involve a player. Both of the average of 2 players' ranks. What? Infernal negotiations. The player gets a bonus in bidding and bonus increases with each additional level of power. They can diplomatic actions. The ritual can last for multiple turns, but okay. Interesting, interesting. How much would it cost for me to increase my intelligence a 4th time? 12 souls, 6 hellfire, and 6 of that thing. Okay, so I can't make any demands for a few turns. Belial. Whoa! He, like, crossed around. So... I guess I could march out that way. But, you know, that takes an order. I think I'm content, as crazy as this is, to just stay back, continue to demand more tribute. I guess something that appears to be great in the single-player game would be to have more charisma, so I could get better tribute. I don't know whether that would hold true for a multiplayer game, though. I'm presuming that players are far more insidious than the AI is. And the AI would be, or the players would be far more fiendish in their demands and their plotting and manipulations than I am. Can't make demand to his Hazel for another 3 turns. And, let's see. This is still Basilbob's territory. I could make some demands from Belial. Hey! Yeah! Yeah! Sure. I have problems, folks. Make a diplomatic effort to Belial. He's a prince of hell. Oh, shit. I can only demand 1 tribute card from him. He is a prince. He is far superior than I am, and I am risking a hell of a whole lot. But, what's done is done. Maybe I should move my legion, like, here next turn, so that I could strike out at both of those locations. Sure, that could be interesting. 7, 6, 7, 5. Okay. Let's go ahead and in turn. Might not matter. For the nth time. I don't know when this demo will end. Game seems fairly intuitive thus far. No concepts that are too difficult for me to understand quite just yet. Tribute from my minions has arrived. Let's take some. What do I need more? I need some of this more. Let's take it. Power is not given, everybody. It's taken. Fine, we'll just stay right there on my stronghold, defend that shit up, and put myself in prime location to threaten either of those spaces. I guess I didn't need that second legion after all, huh? Suppose I could try to bid for a relic to equip on my dude. The Black Heart. Another lit. Ooh! Adds +4 to the tribute roll of the Archfiend who controls this relic? Dude. Do want, although I don't have enough of that. Crap. I just noticed. I gotta pay more attention to these things that I don't have. Prestige +1, +2 destruction roll. Ooh. Again, don't have enough. Resist deceit. No. All damage from ranged attacks is doubled. Ooh. I don't have enough for that. Certainly don't have enough for that. Manuscripts. What do these things do? Oh. There's a 20% chance. Decreases all opponents' charisma attribute by 2 points. Increases a legion's movement rating? Have to overbid this item, I think. Which should better ensure that I get it, at the very least. Let's go ahead and commit the tribute there. I like the idea of that. I like that. If I could do that, and make him be able to move 3 spaces instead of 2, I like that. It sounds good to me. Let's go ahead and in turn. We're approaching an hour of me recording this, folks. I didn't know that would last this long. Maybe this game is worth my $24.99. Maybe this game is worth your $24.99. Belial might not give me my tribute. That's okay. Your Legion Nonus has been forced to halt its march. Ah, crap! I'm not able to enter my stronghold space. Okay. I did not know that. Huh. On the bright side, Legion has been awarded the Infernal Order of the Black Ring. That doesn't sound good. But hey, I got one tribute card, and I won an auction, which is great, so manage my manuscripts. Where would it be? I don't know. Where's that manuscript that I supposedly won? I want it. Do they automatically have it? The answer to that question is a resounding no. If I were a manuscript, where would I be hiding? I can't say. Objectives. I gotta eat 35 souls before the game ends, everybody. So, did my manuscript vanish? Is it not here right now? I don't know. Oh, hey! This actually doesn't cost anything. It seems sneaky. No, I don't want to do that, though. So, I have a manuscript, but I don't know where it is. Interesting. Oh well. So, I'm gonna make a demand from Azazel again. I guess. Maybe that's some sort of bug that was fixed in a later patch. Make diplomatic effort towards Azazel. Ah, crap. I gotta wait another turn, I think. Let's just demand a bunch of tribute. Yeah, and we'll bide my time. It's okay. I am patient. How are we doing, diplomatically here? I'm not doing that bad, all things considered. I could definitely be doing worse. Belilah and Lazazel are in the lead, but I've successfully made demands from them. Perhaps I can continue to do so. Also, I should probably pay more attention to what's going on the map. Also, it's quite possible that I might have been able to take this location. Were I actually attempting to do so? Having too much fun exploring the game, making demands of people. Sue me. No, this video goes on for too much longer. I might concede and decide to divide it up into bits and pieces. What's going on? Beelzebub has taken possession of that thing. Where is that in relationship to me? All the fuck way over there. So yeah, I'm thinking at this point that, this thing is probably going to be taken, too. So, can I make a demand from Azazel yet?
How do I make a demand from Azazel?
Oh, right. Wait. Yeah, where is my manuscript?
Where is my manuscript? I want my manuscript. I want my manuscript.
Interesting. I don't have enough hellfire for that. Damn it. Excuse me. What do I have enough? Stuff for. No. Damn it. I have a lot of ichor now.
but since my manuscript vanished, maybe it takes a turn to arrive. Maybe. So, if I, like, say, look at my things now, nope. You got me, folks. I could try to draw a secret objective, but from what I remember, if you fail to achieve that, you actually lose prestige. Let's, make a demand. I want 4 tribute cards. You're goddamn right, I'm demanding 4. 4 tribute cards. This is madness! And, you know, I could throw down some pain, I guess. That could be fun. Sure. Let's mess around with the world. Why not? Be a dick. You guys are no longer allowed to earn prestige from places of power. The Infernal Conclave announces that prestige generated by places of power will be confiscated by the Conclave for 8 turns. The Conclave token has been drawn this turn, too. So we're drawing closer to the end of the game. I'm in 3rd place. That's not a good thing, by the way, folks. Just so you know, that's not a good thing. I don't think I can take on everything. We may wish to consider, I don't know, acquiring another legion, perhaps? Black Lightning, Fallen, none of you guys are really ranged, I guess except for you, but you don't have a melee attack either. I suppose I will bid on you though, because that could be cool. Alright, we need some of this, we're going to need some more of that, now we need some fire, right here. Now we need some of the circle things. I have the circle things. I am now out of circle things. Okay. Now, for my other action, I will demand tribute. Create a combat card. No. Demand resources. Okay. And in turn. What's gonna happen? What's gonna happen? I don't think my chosen legion can survive all that shit. I'm just saying. We might have a slight problem killing everything. Could be bad. Azazel has refused to concede your demand for 4 tribute cards. You have lost the 7 prestige points. Oh, you're goddamn right I do. Prestige at stake. Champions of single... Go away. Fucking thing popped out. Do you have? I've gotta check. Do you even have a Praetor? No! I don't think he does. He would have to buy one. And for the time being, he doesn't have one. So I can challenge him to single combat. This could go horribly wrong. But since he has a superior force of dudes... Hint, 3 legions. Hint, hint. You know, it could be fun. As these guys march around. Could be amusing.
Although I really would like to take that. Yes, champions of single combat. Commit. Okay. And hey, it doesn't matter because all prestige generated by places of power is being confiscated. Ooh. I definitely need some more of that, and I need some hellfire. It's okay. It's okay. Create a combat card. I could create a combat card for the Illuminatus, should I so wish. Cancel. Bid on a manuscript. I wonder what happened to my manuscript. Maybe it just magically vanished into thin air, everybody. I need some more tribute. Okay, the second legion that I can't do anything with right now, but may be useful in the future. I originally did have a second legion, but I kind of lost it due to my ineptitude, but hey, this is my first time playing the game, okay? It's my first time. Feels like the first time. So I did lose some prestige there in getting that demand failed, but hey, you gotta risk it. You want to become the ruler of hell, you gotta take a few risks, right? And you know, as a matter of fact, I think Azazel has made me so angry right now that I might devote myself the rest of this game to pursuing his death. That's important. Pursuing a man's death. You don't fuck with that. I did say I got that manuscript. Maybe they don't work in the demo. At least not for the player. Barath, your claim of vendetta against Azazel in response to refusal to concede your demands of invalidated by the conclave. You've wagered 9 prestige points. You've elected to resolve the vendetta via single giant battle combat. You must select a praetor by the end of the next turn to act as your champion or forfeit the vendetta. You are my champion. Oh, goodness. I'm gonna have to figure this out now, huh? Oh, boy. I don't have any infernal hacks. The ability to make a standard melee attack move. Boy. Strength of the attack is determined by the number of skulls assigned to it. Up to a maximum of 5 skulls. This could be fun. We will then make a guarded attack. Maybe that's what I should do. Guarded attack. Although, I can't predict what he's gonna do. Ooh, what's the AI gonna do? This is my first time doing this. Let's commit. Fuck, that's not committing. Oh, goodness. And then we'll have a guarded attack. Using all of my stuff. And then we'll have a melee block. Of that, and then we will hope and pray. I don't have anything else I can choose, because I've used up all of his skulls, so we're... We'll do it! Oh, Azazel body, another Infernal Legion. He has a some time to claim a... Praetor, to champion him before everything goes to hell. The game's not completely unfair in that regard. Wow, I'm getting a lot of souls. I'm gonna grab some of that stuff. Okay. But I did make a claim of vendetta. I'm about to try and throw this shit down, folks. 12-6-6. Oh, I still need a little bit more darkness. Dick. Probably should not be devoting myself to committing to raising my intelligence. So, can I do this? Since I chose single combat with a Praetor, that's how our vendetta is going to be decided. So things like legions and stuff, they don't matter. Just go ahead and continue to demand tribute and strengthen myself. Hopefully, Azazel doesn't even get a Praetor as a champion. That would be great. That would be pretty sweet. Okay, so I have these two dudes that really aren't doing anything, haven't been establishing a zone of control. Things I have learned in this game. There have definitely been a lot of things I've learned. It's my first time playing it. Kinda makes sense for me to learn shit. That's a place I can't really attack. Unless I can fly, as it's unclaimed. Prestige plus one, and it gives plus one to destruction, too. At least I do have one place of power. That's nice. The summit of Mount Erebus. Let's go ahead and do this shit. Azazel is totally not my, was not my number one on the threat list, but hey. As soon as he swooped in down here, I decided that was it. Game over, yeah! Choice of folklore has been accepted by the Conclave. You've opted to settle your vita. You have this turn remaining to select your Praetor. Services of the Infernal Legion, known as the Praetor, has been acquired by an unknown dude. Probably Azazel, I would say. I hope he sucks. I hope I know how to do... I hope I know what I'm doing. Yes. That's the right thing to say. I hope I know what I'm doing. I would hate to lose. That would suck. Game over, yeah! Losing is for bitches. And I'm most certainly not that. Rest assured, that is not me. Okay. That works. No, it doesn't. We don't need any ichor. Go ahead and use that. I might need to consolidate some tribute cards. That's the only way I'm going to be able to pay for this. Crap. 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 Yeah, I think so. It's the only way I'm going to be able to pay for that. I'd have to consolidate some tribute cards. Dick. Cancel. Damn it. What if I up my charisma instead? Hey now. There's an idea. That's the spirit. Charisma sausages. We need plus 3 ichor. Now we need plus 6 of the holy flame. Of doom. Ah, crap. I think I'd have to consolidate for this one, too. I don't have the right cards. Yep, I'm not gonna be able to make it. I'm not gonna make it after all. Dick, 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 dick. Oh, well. I tried. Sometimes, folks, your best just isn't good enough. Cancel. Fine. What kind of... Did I draw an event card? I think it was auto-drawn for me, actually. That's a dick card right there. Oh, man. So, if I spin my tribute, and then... Ah, yeah. Interesting. Dig card. Okay, and consolidate tribute here. Alright, so... We place cards in slots. We can consolidate some tribute. So we can pretty much make whatever card we want out of a bunch of 9 slots here. So if I can bind a bunch of these onesies together, I can have more than a 1Z. I can have a powerful Z. So what's my least valuable card now? I have all those ones fused together in a massive display of awesomeness. As if there were any doubt. Six. That's a lot of souls in that. Maybe I just mix and match here. Two. Oh no, then I don't have a lot of flame. Maybe I'll keep a one soul there. And two ichor. That is not ichor, Grimith. We don't have a two in ichor. We only have threes. Fine. There. I've consolidated tribute, and I'm demanding more tribute. And now, in my turn. Alright, let's see how this combat situation works out here. I'm probably going to lose. Hint, hint. I'm just dicking around. Faffing about, as they say. I didn't expect the demo to go on for this long. Champion of Zazel has not appeared. Yes! Yes! I am victorious! I'm so awesome. I'm sorry. I can't hear you over the sound of how awesome I am. Let's use our awesome card there. And now let's contribute this as well. Now I only need a one soul, which I don't have. Crap. Maybe leave that card off. Contribute that. No, I pretty much have to contribute that, don't I? I think so. Nah. Yeah. Well, no. Nah. No, I don't. Hey. Nice. I win. I am the winner. I am the winner. I win. I win. We had ourselves a lovely little vendetta there, too. Oh, yeah, that was great. Who can turn the world on with her smile? Let's see if we can do that again. Oh, man. I don't know whether he has a Praetor. He might have just purchased one, maybe. I would probably have to perform some interesting knowledge seeking upon him. I could do that. How Grimith won a game he did not understand. It's the power of love. My head is starting to hurt from leaving this headset on for so long. I guess I have to go to the main menu to save the game. Can I save the game during the demo? I don't know. By the way, I think I'll be getting a new headset for Christmas. That is one of the things on my wish list, and I do believe it was acquired for me. As my mom asked me about, like, what kind of headset I wanted. Like, you want, like, a USB thing? Or you want, like, one of the cord things that, like, plug into the different slots? And still denying the prestige generated by places of power. Barith. Ah, Barith took that spot. Okay. So how much would increasing this cost? 9 of each. Huh. I have a lot of souls. Ooh. Well, if Grimith is going to be evil pants, I should probably wait until that the man from Azazel comes back, so... Seek out curiosities. I get a man rare script manuscripts for my minions, though. Let's just keep demanding resources. I don't think you get an additional plus to order through charisma, though. That's something to keep in mind. Just go ahead and intern. I'm not doing anything with my legions. This would probably be a terrible idea normally. But... I don't know. I'm doing it blind, everybody! Doing it blind! You know, this place of hell isn't that scary. The music of this game, now that I'm thinking about it, is not that bad. It's not. Maybe the demo only lasts 25 turns? Processor turn up. Yep, there we go! You have reached the turn limit for this demo of Solium Infernum. Full game includes unlimited turns, many more legions, artifacts, relics, and praetors, access to more sizes and layouts, access to play-by-email multiplayer, and a hell of a good time if you like turn-based strategy games. Oh, goodness. You're damn right you can't connect to the internet. I don't allow such tomfoolery. Well, that takes care of the game, folks. Doesn't look like we'll be able to do anything else. So... What? Okay, at least Azazel did concede to my demand. Hey. So what kind of tribute am I looking at here? Oh, I can't see. Sweet. So, final score of this game. You know, for my first time playing, I am third. Third is just as good as dead. Only the first two places really matter in this game, from what I understand. That's okay. I had fun. Alright, so let's go to the main menu here. That, everybody, was Solium Infernum, a turn-based strategy game created by Cryptic Comet. The price of the game is $24.99. Despite how entertaining that was, I don't know whether that would be worth my money at this point in time. I have Christmas gifts to buy, fuck. $24.99 is quite a bit. For the enjoyment value that you get from it, though, especially if you had, like, if you know you had friends who owned the game as well that you could play with, or, you know, you just had, like, people you could trust or something like that to go through an entire game of that, that could definitely have much more intrigue, be far more interesting. I can definitely see that. Came into this game knowing pretty much nothing more than glossing over the instruction manual. And I came out learning quite a bit about it. So, yeah. How about that, folks? I may provide a link, or links or something, like a direct link to like the Solium Infernum page on Cryptic Comet, if you are interested in learning more, perhaps purchasing the game yourself. They've made a few other games, too. I don't remember the names of any of them. So, yeah, you could become your own Archfiend of Hell, manipulate the world to your every whim, hurl insults and make demands from people. Terrain is worth ambition. And failure, that was amusing, though. Vendetta! Ha-ha! So what if you have a superior number of legions? So what if they're higher level? I challenge you to single combat with a praetor. He didn't even submit a champion. Yes! Maybe he bid on some, and the other archfiend just fucked around there. But anyway, yep. That takes care of this video. Hope you all enjoyed, and I will talk to you all later.